All bimolecular reactions, photochemical or thermal, begin by molecular collisions, and this pair of curves shows that there can be quite a difference if one molecule is in an excited state versus the case where both molecules are in the ground state. When the two molecules collide, their electron clouds penetrate one another and their orbitals can interact. What we're going to learn is that because of orbital interactions that are favorable between an excited state molecule and a ground state molecule, that collision complex can be stable and form what's known as an exaplex, or if both molecules' DNA are identical, an examer. If both molecules are in the ground state, we'll learn that that interaction between those orbitals results in repulsion, and so that this results in a high energy state along the potential energy curve. Let's use molecular orbital concepts to understand why that excited state complex is stable, but the pair of ground state molecules, when they collide, the result is repulsive. First, let's take a look at curve 1, where we have an excited state molecule and a ground state molecule. The excited state molecule will have a pair of singly occupied molecular orbitals. We'll say that the lower energy level of these singly occupied molecular orbitals is going to be partially empty, while the upper one is partially filled. That partially empty level can interact with the filled level of the highest occupied molecular orbital of A, and the result will be two new molecular orbitals that are created, one that's lower in energy and one that's higher in energy. The net result of the three electrons that go into that is a net stabilization of one electron. We can see that because a pair of electrons are going to cancel each other. One goes lower and one goes into the upper level, and they basically have energies that are equal and opposite. The result, however, is that there's one stabilized electron, and that's going to contribute to a stabilization of that excited state complex. We also have an additional electron that's stabilizing that's coming from this partially filled level that interacts with the empty level, the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital of molecule A. And so altogether, the excited state complex has two stabilizing electrons. Compare that to case 2, ground state molecules that collide have filled levels that interact. Four electrons go into those molecular orbitals, and the result is that no net electron stabilization results, and that's a repulsive interaction. When the LUMO on D interacts with the LUMO on A, there are no electrons involved at all, and so there's no stabilizing forces that can be present there. And so the result in curve 2 is nothing but repulsive interactions. Because of the stability of the excited state complex, the pair of molecules, D and A, can remain together for a long period of time. Whenever they're together, their orbitals are interacting. And since their orbitals are interacting, it's not surprising that an electron can ultimately be transferred from one molecule to the other. The simplest kind of bimolecular photochemical reactions involve just that process, the process of transfer of an electron from D to A, which we'll look at more closely in the next webcast.